What's up, Cardboard Nation? Welcome to BOGO, GoGTS Live, the Hobbies web show. That's right. You are basically getting two shows for the low cost of one, with one costing you absolutely nothing to begin with. So, I don't know. What's better than a BOGO? This, I guess. So, thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Rob Bertrand, at VOTC, Voice of the Collector on Twitter. Over there, Ivan Lovgren, at Watch the Breaks on Twitter. The reason you're getting two shows, we're off next week. I know, I'm sorry. So what do? We guaranteed like a five-hour marathon tonight. No, it's not going to be that long. But it was really amazing how this week transpired, and it just kept rolling and rolling. And the next thing I knew, I'm like, I got to split these segments up. We got this, ooh, we got that. And then even at the last minute, I got a package from Onyx today.
Whoa, so breaky.
Yeah, no doubt. So what's going on, dude?
Not too much. Well, a little bit. I'm actually in the midst of a real-time eBay dispute trying to get
right
some information from eBay on interesting thing. You know, I hate to actually talk about this because, Rob, I don't want to perpetuate scamming, but there's actually a pretty easy scam, possibly, unless eBay and I's conversation produces some fruition, that I feel like is being pulled on me. I've mentioned it once before. Remember my big BGS kerfuffle?
Yes, Heimer Candelaria. So
yeah,
we're
yeah,
here for
so,
you. Come on, let it what? Flow.
Let it flow? Okay, cool. Well, I just wanted to make sure that you were on board with me, too. Yeah, so the Heimer Candelaria, we talked about the BGS side of it, but the initial issue was I sold a high-value prospect card, and then he got injured while it was in transit, and the value dropped, and it magically showed up with a big, giant gash right in the front, like somebody had taken a hammer or a pickaxe at it.
To the card? Now,
well, to the slab, because remember, this is a graded card.
Oh.
Now, okay. I wouldn't put that past USPS with my recent experience with them. However, the timing of it seemed rather funny. So, if you've been following me at all lately, you know I've been flipping some prospects that were really hot at the beginning of the season. Well, one of those guys has cooled off somewhat, and looking at some sold comps, I accepted a high offer. And now the card is maybe $100, $150 less. This time I shipped with insurance, of course, but I got a message from the buyer today saying, hey, it showed up and there's some small scratches on the case. It's not going to fit into my collection. I want a refund.
I hate people.
Yeah.
No, what happened is he hit the injured reserve. He realized that he overpaid for the card and now is trying to screw you to get his money back. People suck.
Yeah. Well, but that's the thing is that arguably you could do that. Like you could buy a card and then wait out the 29 days, claim it was scratched, and then sell it back if the card doesn't shoot up in value in the meantime. Now, the flip side is maybe he is 100% right. Maybe my pictures weren't perfect. And that is that. That's why I'm trying to talk to eBay and find out, and they're actually being pretty responsive, so maybe we could get a conclusive answer on this. Is someone buying the card, or are they buying the case?
The slab?
When they buy a graded card, yeah.
Because I think
the card is clearly still in the exact condition it was shipped in. It's in a slab.
So, yeah, chances are this guy got it, scratched it himself, and yeah, people suck, dude. Here's the thing, though. Mm-hmm. People suck.
That's the same thing you just said. But, I guess that's the point that's needed.
No, I mean, it's so frustrating. It's just, well, what's your return policy?
So it says no returns, and that's especially after the news from last week that returns now, your PayPal fees are not going to be credited back to you on return. So it could cost
no
me 3% to do this return.
No returns. So but, what makes this person think that it's returnable if there's no returns?
It doesn't fit into their collection based on an as-pictured condition, you know.
Yeah.
So, but that actually leads me, Rob, right into our poll of the week.
Do it!
I love this poll of the week. If you don't know what the poll of the week is, well, if you're watching the show anyways, you need to follow us on Twitter. I know there's a lot of social networks out there. You don't necessarily need to join Etsy or Pinterest or this one or that one just to engage with us. You can watch us on one network, but make sure you follow us on Twitter, because that's how we're going to pull winners for the giant amount of prizes we're going to have tonight from all of these box breaks. I'm already cross-eyed over it. But that's also why we do a queue of the week to get things started. So it's our pinned tweet right now. So go out there and vote at the top of the page, twitter.com/GoGTSLive. And the reason that it applies to what I just said is, the poll is, you can have one of the following Holy Grail cards of various sports for your PC. You can never flip it. Which do you choose? So unlike values fluctuating, I don't want this because of that, and the cost went down. This is what card, if you had to hold it forever, would you want? 1952 Topps Mickey Mantle, 86-87 Fleer Jordan rookie card, 2000 Contenders Brady autograph, or an 09 Bowman draft Mike Trout autograph. Noticeably absent is a T206 Honus Wagner, I think because just due to the scarcity, that would blow away everyone else. Rob, the data so far suggests the 1952 Topps Mickey Mantle. I sincerely wonder how many people may have been thinking flipping still when they guessed that or picked that. But it doesn't surprise me. Baseball does tend to be the most popular. My personal answer is not that. What's your personal answer?
Come on. 86-87 Fleer Jordan.
Yep. That's me as well. If I could have one beautiful thing to put on my office wall or on my mantle.
Now, maybe some of you who voted, because it's 53% and outweighing, you know, the other three combined, obviously. And maybe some people were thinking that it will be worth more to whoever I leave it for. I'm not flipping it per se. But just that on my shelf, that's something I'm proud of. It goes with my PC. Yeah, Fleer Jordan.
Yeah, I was going to say, or after Rob and Ivan die, I can flip it. Like, the rules stop changing. No. That said, it doesn't fully surprise me. Baseball does generally win overall among collectors the popularity contest. But 22% of you, including Rob and I, say 86-87 Fleer Jordan. But hey, we just switched it up. That poll is no longer pinned. Now the pinned tweet is our Periscope broadcast of the show. So even on Twitter, you can watch live right there. If you are watching live there, give us some hearts. Just double tap your screen or click those share buttons. Let some more people know about it. I don't know if we have a bonus giveaway tonight yet, but we oftentimes do. So I highly recommend tweeting that or retweeting that tweet to tell some people.
We have an unclaimed auto from X-Files last week.
Well, there's only one way to win that. It's retweet the Periscope tweet, which is now pinned.
Kevin McNulty, right there.
All right, X-Files. X-Files, that's the song for that, right? X-Files.
So, X-Files. As before we bring on our guest, Dave Yokin, CEO of Collectible.com, best known for their groundbreaking collectible app, which is like a historical price guide and universal auction finder. I want to give you guys a rundown of what we have going on the rest of the night. We have a brief hobby happening segment, and it's good because we have so much other stuff going on. We have two box break segments, two hot in the shop segments, a quick hello from someone in between or right before the box breaks part two. And while Ivan's pulling winners towards the end of the show, I'll give you guys my as best spoiler-free review as I can of the now available baseball documentary, Jack of All Trades, which I
baseball
watched this week.
Baseball card documentary.
Yes. And so one other thing, just real quick. I wrote an article on the blog, GoGTS.net, this week about my experience at WrestleMania and the Transcendent VIP experience. If you're at all interested, check it out. It was a truly once-in-a-lifetime incredible experience, and special thanks to GTS for allowing me to go, Tops for having me, and if you have any questions about that, hit me up on Twitter, and be sure to check out the article. All right. So let's shift gears here. Wonderful. Let's bring on our guest, Dave Yokin, CEO of collectible.com, twitter.com/collectible app, available on Android and iOS. Dave, this is long overdue, as you and I were talking about. Welcome to GoGTS Live, the Hobbies Web Show, sir.
Rob, it's great to be here. I've been waiting for years to do this. We're finally here.
Well, I'm glad we could make it happen. You know, we first met at a national a couple years ago, and I was familiar with the app at that point. But basically, what re-caught my attention was your guys' engagement on social media, particularly Twitter. And I said, you know what? I said we'd have them on, and it just never got around to it, making that happen this week. And I was so glad you were available.
Excellent.
But tell people a little bit about the app, because I also know that we've got some news about a pending marketplace launch. But let's talk about the historical price guide and the all-in-one auction portal.
Finally. Yeah, so first of all, thanks so much for having me. It's really great being here. I got a little bit of an echo, so see if I can turn down my mic. Okay.
I can hear you.
All right, so Collectible is a, as you mentioned, free app for iOS and for Android, and for any and all collectors. And basically what we do is we aggregate auction data, and we pull data from all kinds of different sources, particularly auction houses. We have 26 auction houses that we pull data from, and basically it's if an auction house is running an auction, we actually pull in all their listings. You can see the items and prices in real time. You can go through the pictures, read the descriptions, track items. And I think one of the coolest features is the fact that you can actually submit your wish list. Any cards you're looking for, any memorabilia you're looking for, any autographs you're looking for, you can submit the items in the app. And when a new auction comes online, we check the wish list. We send you a notification if there's a match. So you really don't have to do any work to find that needle in the haystack. We actually do it all for you. And just this past week, we introduced our first eBay seller, which is a PWCC marketplace. And they have a ton of great listings and so many different items to look through. It's kind of mind-boggling, actually. But so we aggregate all
that data. That's a great account to land.
We also have an integrated historical price guide. And basically what that is we actually have well over 2 million historical prices dating back almost 20 years. And that is data from all of these different auction houses, including all the auctions from PWCC and all of these other third-party auction houses that we aggregate. And it's a free feature in the app. So if you're looking for a price on a Mike Trout baseball card, you know, you just put it into the app, you search for it, you look under closed listings. If you want to look in the historical section, you have instantaneous access, completely free. And we actually have, I would say, probably one of the most comprehensive and broadest data sets, because not only do we cover graded cards, but you can find historical prices on autographs and all kinds of memorabilia, items that have sold at auction at one point or another. And it's all available free in the app, again, for iOS and Android. And so basically, it's the app as it exists currently is a information portal for collectors. It's basically a way to pull in all this information in a really nice, easy-to-use format. And we just bring it all to you. And that's what Collectible is at the moment.
That's really cool. If I can, Dave, I'm curious because very few people get into this industry with no background in collecting. What was it that made you think of this idea originally? I know we're going back a few years and we've got exciting new stuff to talk about, but where did this whole thing come from for you?
You know, I actually have a bit of a tech background, and I was a card collector as a kid, and I could never quite kick the collecting bug. When I sold my first company, it was an IT consulting company, I got back into cards pretty heavily, and I was really focused on vintage cards. That's kind of my my area of expertise. But I couldn't help but notice how difficult it was to keep track of all the auctions. You know, if you're looking for a specific card, I was putting together an old set, a T204 Ramley set, and I had a couple cards I needed on my own wish list that I, you know, just kept in pen and paper and next to my computer, and I would just go searching online to see where I could find these cards. And I'll never forget, I actually went to an auction site. An auction had just closed, probably the day before, and they had the card. They had one of the cards I was looking for, and I had no idea
of
that
course.
It had actually been listed and offered in this auction. I would have obviously bid on it heavily. And I said to myself, you know, thinking about this sort of paradigm of, you know, all of these different auction houses, and there are close to 100 of them in the industry. There are close to 100 auction houses that sell sports memorabilia on a regular basis. To try to find the cards you're looking for, you really have to have all the time in the world to, you know, look through the catalogs that get sent to you, or go on the websites, or keep track of the auctions that are happening. It's just kind of a frenzied market. And I said, there's got to be a better way. There's got to be a sort of a tech solution for this. And that sort of, you know, created the genesis of the idea for Collectible.
So you're the epitome of necessity is the mother of invention.
Absolutely. I'm what we call a user entrepreneur. I only build products that I would use personally.
That's really cool. Now, let me ask you, just from a data standpoint, we tend to default to eBay for a lot of things, especially when it comes to pricing.
Yes.
With what you're seeing in the Collectible app, because I imagine that your days are spent seeing all these things come in there, what actual percentage of the marketplace do you attribute to eBay versus the 100 plus other auction houses that you see?
Yeah, you know, so we actually did a lot of research on the industry just to get a sense of, you know, how big is the sports memorabilia market in the U.S.? I think it was kind of an exercise that we needed to do for a couple of reasons. Number one, we wanted to understand where the opportunities were in the market for a company like Collectible, which is a fairly unique sort of a tech-focused, you know, startup in the sports memorabilia market. And there aren't many companies like us. But also, you know, from the standpoint of the industry, it seems that, you know, there's the industry is growing and it's doing some really incredible things, but there's really never been any hard data put together on how big the market is and where marketplace activity takes place. So, you know, we actually did quite a bit of research over the past year or two, and actually came up with some really fascinating data about the size of the market in the U.S. As being worth over $5.5 billion in terms of annual trading value. And to answer your question in a kind of a long-winded way, eBay handles about 80-85% of that market activity. And from our perspective, it was sort of fascinating to look at and to sort of see, you know, what's really happening in this industry. It sort of formed a lot of the decisions we've made in terms of where a Collectible is heading, you know, in the future. But eBay, you know, eBay does well over $4 billion of sales in sports memorabilia. So that's, you know, cards, autographs, and the broad memorabilia category.
The app right now, as it stands, if I understand correctly, is strictly focused around auctions as comparison to fixed marketplaces,
yep.
Correct?
Yep.
So no Check Out My Cards, no Beckett Marketplace, things like that. So this is strictly cards that show up at auctions.
Yeah, so again, we have 26 auction houses that we aggregate. The majority of them are sort of third-party auction houses like the Hunts, Memory Lanes, the Mile Highs, the Love of the Games, and then there's, you know, PWCC, which we've just started to integrate from eBay. We do not have any aggregated data from fixed price marketplaces like Beckett or COMC yet, but we're certainly, you know, open to opportunities to partner with those companies, you know, down the road.
So when you say that there's no fixed market data, does that mean that $5.3 billion number is not counting the fixed markets?
Well, what we did is we extrapolated data based on some market assumptions in the fixed price market. You know, the problem in our industry is that there are no real industry watchdogs that survey, you know, dealers and companies, marketplaces, about how much sales they push through their channel. So what we did is we basically made some educated guesses about the size of that category of the market, but they are essentially included in the $5.4 billion number.
Okay, awesome. Thank you. I'm a bit of a data nerd, so this part is really exciting to me. I know, though, that you also have some other exciting features that you're launching.
Yes.
So if you want to tell us a little bit about where Collectible App is going, yes, we'd love to hear that as well.
So, you know, this has been a fascinating ride for me as a, you know, starting up a company in an industry that I personally love, where there really isn't much of a support ecosystem to, you know, to help companies at a very early stage who are trying to disrupt the market. And, you know, our focus has always been to make the industry more accessible and more transparent, which is why, you know, as opposed to charging for access to the data that we publish, it's all free. You know, we believe that it's important that that the data is democratized. It's kind of, you know, distributed freely to everyone who wants to see it. But as we've progressed, you know, going back to the market research we did on the size of the industry, you know, looking at where the majority of the transactions are handled, you know, we sort of came to the conclusion that it may be time to give the industry another alternative as a marketplace to, you know, the sort of the big elephant in the room, which is eBay. And eBay has obviously done some incredible things, and they've innovated, you know, starting when they launched their marketplace 24 years ago. But we have some really interesting ideas about how to really address some of the concerns that have come up, you know, in regards to where eBay is going, where and what eBay is doing now. And we're really excited to bring some new, fresh ideas to this notion of an alternative marketplace in the industry. And what we did is we put together a group of investors who've come on board, including, you know, several people who have decades of experience in the industry, a very, very excited group of passionate collectors. And, you know, we've all sort of coalesced around this idea that there should be alternatives for people in the industry who want to buy and sell from each other in sort of a new sort of peer-to-peer marketplace. And so the next phase for the company is a marketplace that we are launching this year, where buyers and sellers will be able to buy and sell with each other. And as an interesting side note, one of the biggest pieces of feedback that we get from our users pretty much every day is how can we sell through the Collectible App? So not only is it this sort of validated in our mind from a research standpoint, an anecdotal standpoint, sure, but also from all of the data that we're receiving from our users who are saying, you know, we love your app, but we want to interact with it more than just, you know, consume the information. We want to be able to buy and sell as well. So that's kind of the next evolutionary phase of Collectible.
That's really exciting for you. So congratulations.
Thank you.
Look forward to, you know, how that progresses. We're dropping a link to download the Collectible App into the various chat rooms that we're broadcasting through. You just enter your phone number and it'll know if you need an iOS or Android version. Yep. And right now the marketplace is going to be through invitation only. So go to collectible.com and click on the Join Our Marketplace. Fill out that information if that's something that you're interested in participating in their peer-to-peer marketplace.
Rob, if I may, real quick, I just have to share this with Dave. Brew Crew fan Jeff in our YouTube chat downloaded the app during this conversation and says, I've already found a card I've been looking for with the app less than 5 minutes.
Love it. See, this is what it's all about for us. That's the type of validation that makes all the hard work of building a startup I love that. That's my drug. That's what keeps us going. So I appreciate the feedback. And anytime I hear somebody say, you know, I found something I've been looking for years, you know, just by putting my wish list in the app and you guys told me about an item that I wouldn't have known about, was available from an auction house I'd never even heard of before. And, you know, that's just great. So I'm super thrilled. And you know, anyone who wants to download the app and check it out, it's completely free. Feedback, we'd love to hear, you know, how we can improve. Feel free to email me directly. It's just dave@collectible.com. And, you know, we're just going to keep improving and making things better. And, you know, just trying to make the industry as transparent and as accessible and as trusted as it can be. And it's such a great industry. You know, as I said, collecting is kind of in my DNA, and just being part of this ecosystem is just so much fun. So that's great to hear.
Well, with how big you are already, I don't know that we're necessarily moving the needle. The amount of messages I've already seen across our 6 different chats and our Twitter feed, just joined, just signed up for 4 different auctions, or just started following 4 different auction houses. How did I not know about this before? Yeah. We appreciate you coming on. I know we've got a packed show tonight, Rob, but I got to pick his brain some more. You mentioned feedback. Well, what about feedback? What's the fee going to look like in this marketplace? Can you tell us what that looks like?
Well, I can say that we're going to be impressively competitive. I think you guys, whoever takes a look at us from a comparison standpoint to other marketplaces, are going to be very impressed with what we're offering. I'll leave it at that now, but more details will trickle out as we get closer to launch. But you know, fees are going to be one of our strong points.
Awesome. You know, you can't buy better advertising than the feedback that you just got based on, you know, completely unscripted, you know, which is awesome. So I'm very happy that in some small way we can help get the word out, because we certainly have been supportive and appreciative of your efforts from the very beginning. And we'll stay in touch and circle back, and we'll have you back on after the marketplace launch. And if you ever need anything, you know how to find me. So thanks for coming on, Dave. Best of luck, and we'll talk soon.
Thank you so much, Rob. Appreciate it, guys. Have a great night, and look forward to coming on again.
Thanks so much, Dave. Dave Yokin, CEO of Collectible.com, the collectible app, and soon-to-come peer-to-peer marketplace. How cool was that, guys?
Oh, Rob, I was biting my tongue so much because, you know me, I'm a bit of a talker, but I just wanted to let him share as much as possible. I was a little confused, and I've actually never signed up for Collectible before this, even though I've heard about it or seen it. That is legit, and I'm going to be signing up as soon as we get but how cool. I saw the chat rooms were just eating it up as well. Man, that's what's fun about this, Rob. Thanks for going out and getting that sort of person for the thing. And think about this. I've seen a lot of posts lately about side hustle, and there is so much room still in the hobby for innovation. There's so much room for breakthrough. You don't have to make the same thing that someone else is doing and just try to jump on a bandwagon. Just think about, what do you love? Here's a guy from the tech background who had a problem, and he went out and solved it. And how many of us know that problem?
He's like, why do I have to keep track of 100 auction houses and eBay to find what I'm looking for? I'm going to fix that. And so he did.
Well, and I love it because, you know, I'm a bit of a simpleton where I rely on eBay for most of that. I'm like, I just don't have the time. And for better or for worse, it's like I'm not that diehard of maybe a set collector of vintage where something like that falling through the cracks will kill me. But I love the idea already of more information, easier, right at your fingertips. you know, I think it's great, and I love what it was born out of, and I love what it sounds like it's turning into.
Yeah, it's really exciting. I first met him at the National in Atlantic City, I want to say like 3 years ago, and it just, it's one of those things where I kept meaning to have him on, and then this, that, and the other thing. And what I told him, what prompted me to get him on finally was they've been a lot more active on social media lately, especially Twitter. Mm-hmm. And some of the things have made me chuckle and take notice, and I'm like, oh, I gotta reach out to Dave.
Oh, I saw one tweet of theirs today. Since you mentioned that, first off, remember it's collectable, not collectible with an I. It's collectable with an A. But this storage locker, this news article, not even a news article, just Terrell Owens apparently auctioned off a storage unit that he owned.
Wow, and, we might learn about more of that in Hobby Happenings.
Full of sports memorabilia. Well, yeah, but I already learned about it from the collectible app Twitter. Did I just spoiler alert something?
You have got to start looking at that before.
I just have to. The last couple weeks I have. Today we just got so sidetracked with that.
I sent it to you yesterday. It takes 2 minutes. You really have to. Ugh. And I was in such a good mood. All right.
You can still be in a good mood, Rob. We've got a great show. Lots more great stuff to happen.
So, yes, with that said, let's check out what's happening in the hobby in this week's Hobby Happenings. So, you know, baseball's great. We all know that.
And the best.
It absolutely is born of the fact that it's made for great moments. It lives and breathes by the very definition of great moments. Last year generated one that was truly worthy of cardboard and will be immortalized on an Allen and Ginter card this summer. Check this out.
Being called the miracle on the mound.
A nun threw out the ceremonial first pitch at a baseball game and delivered it as though guided by a higher power. ABC's John Donovan was there.
With a mitt on her hand and a spring in her step, Sister Mary Jo Sobiech took the mound last night before the White Sox played, not the shy type at all, to throw the ceremonial first pitch. And that, she's signaling to her departed mom, her angel in the outfield, she said later. Now, Sister Mary Jo, she has an arm. She used to coach sports at Marion Catholic High School, so when the honor was offered, she accepted, warming up some in the parking lot outside the stadium, and then inside, hobnobbing with Sox manager Rick Renteria, asking him to warm up again with one of his players.
She stepped back at about 45 feet and threw a bullet. I was like, wait a minute. And I said, can you play for us? And she said, sure.
But now it was for real. And was Sister Mary Jo at long last nervous? Well, this little maneuver says no, she was not. And then here's the pitch and right down the middle. And so a little celebration in front of everybody. And then back inside.
Thank you, everybody. This was wonderful. Appreciate it. Go, Mary Catholic.
That number on her back, 60, she says, is the speed of her fastball. Nope, not shy at all. And yes, the nun has an arm. John Donvan, ABC News.
Strike! That's some nun, huh? Sister Mary Jo Sobiech of Marion Catholic High School in Chicago Heights, Illinois, is excited about the honor and said that Topps is paying her $1,000, which she plans to donate to a scholarship fund at Marion Catholic High School that's named after her. In addition to the base card, collectors should be on the hunt for autographed versions and relic versions. Wait, what? Yep, you guessed it. Game-used non-veil cards will now be a thing when Allen and Ginter hits hobby shelves July 17th.
A true hobby icon. Joe Adell cares. The Angels' young prospect, first-round draft pick last year, respects the game, his fans, and collectors. His goal for a recent marathon autograph session was to not only sign as many cards as possible, but to produce something collectors would be proud of owning. Adele said, "I want to be quick, but I want whoever has this card to see every letter." He said that as he dropped a pen to paper and produced a signature that is clearly legible. Don't we wish more players took this much pride in their signature? Well, thanks, Joe.
Most definitely.
He's even got only two letters in his first name, and he still works it out. No excuses.
No excuses. Well, you may have heard, in fact, I know you've heard from Ivan, that not even Terrell Owens is immune from what happens when storage units' fees go unpaid. TMZ Sports reported this week that some random dude in Georgia made off with quite the haul of some awesome NFL memorabilia contained in the Hall of Famer's storage unit, and now T.O. is scrambling to get it back. The items in Owens' old storage unit in Atlanta were auctioned off after he stopped making payments to the company. T.O. said he had no idea his stuff was about to be auctioned off and added that his, quote, people, because we all have people, had been trying to make contact with the storage company for years, but had been getting the runaround, He's upset he didn't receive a heads up before his valuables were sold, and that he is very interested in getting in contact with the current owner to reclaim his memories. The man who bought all the stuff, James Rice of Jan's Used Furniture in Griffin, Georgia, told TMZ he's more than willing to give the stuff back to its rightful owner.
Makes it seem less like a spoiler and more like a teaser, because I did not know the story was going to go there. That's shocking. The results from a couple of high-profile auctions we've told you about in recent weeks are now available. Since we know you love data, let's dive in. The collection of 27 game-used bats from every member of the 500 Home Run Club sold through Mile High's spring auction garnered a final bid of over $300,000. Also, the best-ranked set collection of Willie Mays cards on the PSA set registry sold for a combined $1.2 million this past week through Memory Lane.
Holy cow. As you may or may not know, the PWCC 500 is an index of investment-grade worthy trading cards. It continues to outpace the S&P 500 through the first quarter of 2019. The trading card index saw an increase in value of 15% to the S&P's 12.3%. However, as Ivan warns us, past performance is not an expectation or indicator of future value or gains. In other industry-related business news, Sports Collectors Daily reported that shares of Collectors Universe, the parent company of PSA, hit a 52-week high this week at $17.82 per share.
The recently released second edition of the T206 collection, The Players and Their Stories, was awarded a gold medal at the 31st Annual Independent Book Publishers Association Benjamin Franklin Awards in Chicago. Sports Collectors Daily reports that reprints of the cards were originally used in the first edition, but the new edition includes hundreds of pictures showcasing some high-quality original cards featuring the players who comprise the 504-card set. The second edition is 256 pages in hardcover that offers new chapters on things like the Lucky Seven find of rare Ty Cobb cards. The story is eloquently told by Collectors Universe president Joe Orlando. Another chapter in the book focuses on the various T206 backs that you can find. The new edition of the T206 collection, The Players and Their Stories, is available now on Amazon.
And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings. Good stuff.
Very cool stuff.
And I have the first edition of that book.
Such a twitch. A twist, yeah, it was, in that story.
It was, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, his people had been...
his people. Hey, to be fair, I have waited in my previous life on a number of athletes, a number of Dallas Cowboys athletes, in fact, who were some of the worst tippers I've ever experienced. And Terrell Owens was always a gentleman and always tipped well.
Fair enough.
That's all I have to say about that.
All right. Well, we've been talking about sports cards. Anybody want to look at some and win some?
Ooh, maybe. Let's fondle those cards.
our part one of our box break segments tonight features some Topps products, kicking things off with Alliance of American Football, which we talked about in detail last week. I think it was, I don't want to attribute it to the wrong person, so I'm going to say that one of our fans on Twitter brought up a good point. I think at this point you kind of got to look at this product now as 84 to 86 USFL. You never know what might come out of here a few years later. I mean, isn't it home of Steve Young's rookie card? So is there someone potentially in here? You just don't know. We know there's plenty of cool, relatively obscure coaches autographs, and you get three autographs a box. So let's tear into this and find out what we've got.
While you do that, Rob, I've got some possibly bad news from eBay.
In a really nice
description. First off, here's why I don't attack people or companies. It's because guess what? Honey attracts more flies than vinegar. As the saying kind of goes, I think.
Something like that. Close enough.
Since I've been nice to eBay, their Ask eBay team gives me answers. They actually give me answers in nice, thought-out conversations. But they do say that the answer to my question of, are they buying the case or are they buying the card is, it depends. It's really about the buyer's intent. If the buyer's intent is to display rather than to use, the container is highly important, because I used an analogy of Play-Doh since I just bought some Play-Doh on eBay as well. The container is highly important, and the customer would want it to be described accurately so they know what to expect. If the container were scratched or discolored in any way, but those defects weren't fully disclosed in the listing, we would have a valid, not as described, return on our hands.
Cameron Kelly, red parallel, number to 99, rookie defensive back.
Hey, cool. So that's at least interesting to get an answer, right?
Sure.
I share that absolutely, because how many of you have never gotten an answer from eBay? And it's not because I have any more clout or anything. It's just sometimes you just got to ask directly. But if you ask nicely, they'll actually listen and respond. And so
there are designated rookie cards in here as first-time pro players. Future Stars cards. That one of Dustin Vaughn. Wouldn't it be crazy if somebody did blow up out of here and all of a sudden people are going back looking for unopened boxes of Alliance of American Football?
Well, I know that's something that Jonathan Coker, one of our viewers, hopes. He's a giant Christian Hackenberg fan. In fact, actually, earlier in the YouTube chat, he responded to our poll of the week question with Christian Hackenberg Prizm 1/1. And Christian Hackenberg did get an opportunity in this league. So I know there's some people out there chasing these guys.
Matt Sims. So they must have gotten all this photography during padded practices, because they're in their uniforms, but you can clearly see the seats are empty. But at least you know what I mean. They're in their uniform. I was kind of thinking that this was going to be an entire set of like like posed shots on the field. So at least they've got their uniforms on and stuff. That's cool. And truth be told, the league was competitive. It was, from all accounts, it was fun to watch. It's just comes down to money. It couldn't sustain. The interest certainly seemed there.
Yep. The silliness of billionaires or multimillionaires. Billionaires. They were billionaires. I looked that up last week in comparison to Vince McMahon. They were both billionaires. Vince McMahon is a slightly more billionaire billionaire.
Future star Larry Rose.
Huge shout out to Donnie Springfield, just subscribed with Twitch Prime, which means that subscription didn't even cost him anything since he's an Amazon Prime user. But he's helping support the shipping that we send out. What is it? A subscription is $4.99 and we get like 40% of that. So you paid Steve one package for us this month.
Burrier?
I'm not saying that sarcastically. We really do appreciate it.
Here is a red parallel number to 99 of Ladarius Gunter. Special shout out to viewer, fan, friend of the program, Jason Rocco, who was in attendance at the Transcendent Experience. I think we met a few years ago in Atlantic City, so it was good to see you again. Hope you enjoyed yourself. It was very fun. Whoa, this is this one's numbered to just 25. This is a Future Stars parallel. Ooh. Of Will Davis, numbered to just 25.
Now, hold on. Hold that up there. I'm going to get a picture.
Hold on. Hold it now. Hold it now.
I could be wrong. I'm going to have to double check, cross check my sources. I feel like Will Davis is one of the guys that already got signed to an NFL team upon the collapse of the league. So let me double check that. And that might actually be exactly the type of card that you were talking about, Rob.
Charlie Ebersole.
Oh, wow. There's actually two Will Davises that played cornerback in the AAF. That's even crazier.
All right. We've got our first auto. It's on card. Dante'o Dye Jr., wide receiver. He's a guy that might definitely get picked up. I wonder what the QR code on the backs of the cards does or goes to. Right there. See what I'm talking about.
Played for the Buccaneers for a little while, it looks like. Out of Heidelberg University. No updates on his current status since the Orlando Apollos folded last week.
Zach Mettenberger.
Dodgers Dennis.
Future Steve Young. Who can tell?
He's a righty, though. How can he be the future Steve Young if he's a righty?
That's true. We do got a quarterback auto. Luis Perez of the Birmingham Iron.
Nice. That may be is that the first quarterback in a starter jacket?
Since Pro Set?
Ever.
There's Christian Hackenberg. Michael
Looks like
Vick.
The Eagles just signed this Luis Perez. So, hey, there's something. There is something, Rob. I'm definitely putting that down on the giveaway cards. Can you imagine this guy, just 24 years of age, if he steps in, Eagles need to throw him in at quarterback and goes crazy.
Right.
Next, Kurt Warner right there. That's who you just hit.
Denard Robinson.
You can follow him on Twitter at Perez Lewis QB.
Kalane Ross, future star.
Hey, Stock and PMS is tuned in because he just tweeted us. That would be once and future Ram, Luis Perez Auto.
Mike like Singletary. That.
Getting some love in the Periscope too with the hearts there. What about over on Facebook? Y'all clicking those emojis?
So there is his Luis Perez's base rookie card. I'll pair that up with the auto.
Very cool. Now, are the autos always on a different picture?
Looks like it. Terry Pelopi, blue parallel, numbered to 50.
Yeah, I wonder if that's because they actually produced the autos in time for the practice where they went and got these things. Because it looks like the
Dennis
autos are...
Dennis Erickson.
A lot of the autos are on much more posed, like against a backdrop, like it was at a press conference or something. So that's probably... That would be my guess as to why that is. The only one
I'd
listed
say that's
on eBay,
a fair assessment.
Yeah, the only one listed on eBay is listed for $59.99. That may be one of the best cards that you could possibly hit out of this, Rob. Recently sold for $29.99. So,
hey,
cool.
That's not shabby.
No. Like I said, that may be one of the best cards from this. In fact, let's look at Topps AAF, recently sold. Oh, there are actually, surprisingly, the blank back one of ones. Those are selling for a good clip. One just sold for $41 of some guy named Akram Wadley.
Trevor Knight, future star.
$23 for a blank back 101, 22. Someone's collecting the set, it looks like. But as far as autographs go, Trent Richardson sold for less than $35. Oop, sounds like there's some potty training going on downstairs. Sorry if you guys can hear that.
Lori Locust, you were talking about women involved. She's a defensive assistant, or was.
Very cool. Look at that, giving cards to the coaches.
And we have our third autograph is Duke Thomas. Duke Thomas, cornerback. Also a rookie.
Yeah, see, getting there with the posed picture, with the hoodie jacket, trying to stay warm.
Just three packs left. I'm going to just... Plays through these real quick, make sure we're not missing anything huge. And then I'm going to tell you what we're going to do.
Call me crazy. I find the controversy over female coaches kind of silly.
Yeah,
because
I do
for
too.
Better or for worse, like you almost can't afford to give a token female coach a role.
Like, no, I mean you're setting yourself up for a lawsuit. You gotta know you. They know their craft. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
There's Dr. Jen Welter, defensive specialist.
I mean, it's a little bit like, you know, take these comments as just off the top of my head thinking, but like Jackie Robinson and the color barrier,
Troy
in
Polinella.
The sense of, it's like, not just anybody could have done that. They needed someone that they knew could. Perform.
Yep.
You know,
all right.
Like they needed the best.
So we are definitely going to give away the Luis Perez combination. We are also going to give away the two other autographs, but I'm going to split the parallels up. So there's going to be like a little. So you're going to get this guy's.
Who
so Duke Thomas
guys,
auto.
Duke Thomas.
And Dante Dye.
With two E's.
Okay.
All right, awesome.
So three winners.
So I mentioned it at the start of the program. However, if you were not watching, that's fine. I'll mention it again. The way you enter to win is you follow us on Twitter, and you look for the tweets that are going to go up that are going to have the items that you can win. And they generally say, retweet this to enter to win. And that's what you're going to have to do, is retweet it. And make sure you're following us on Twitter. And then also make sure you watch through the end of the show, because as essentially the prize is we want to go to people that put up with us. No, we want to go to people that enjoy the show and are able to all the way through. So we announce the winners live at the end of the show, and you have to be watching to win. No going out and tagging people on Twitter and saying, hey, you won. We chewed them out enough last week for other things. We don't need to chew out anybody this week, right?
Yeah, this one's going to be quick. This one's Inception. One autograph or autograph relic card per box. Topps Inception MLB Baseball. It's a chunker. Okay.
All right.
Got some base of George Springer.
Now, while we fondle these cards, Rob, let me just go out and say this is the best looking year of Inception ever. Now, I feel like back in the day, it used to be like three autos per box when they first started, and now it's down to just one. So it is still a big sort of risk product. But man, on the secondary market, especially those base cards, that is a good looking card this year with the extra little bit of color. Remember, it was a little dull in the past.
These pop. This like this green parallel of rookie. Ooh. Jake Cave.
Nice. Rookie card, green parallel. Number 299, 75?
Not numbered. But this next parallel, pink or red one of rookie Ryan O'Hearn of the Kansas City Royals is numbered to 99.
Ah, it's just too bad he's a Royal. I mean, come on, you can have a 35-game hit streak as a Royal and it's not even national news or top 10.
You like patch autos numbered to 25? We got one. Ooh. Of Danny Jansen. Boom! Look there at that patch.
Hold that to the light. That looks good. So is that our one auto?
That's it.
Nice low numbered chunky patch. I'm all in. Are you all in? I'm all in.
All right. Next up, we take to the pitch with some Topps Finest 2018-19 UEFA Champions League Soccer, two autographs per master box. I'm assuming one per mini then. Thanks to Suze for hooking us up. Always coming through on that chrome stock and splashy designs. Cornerstones insert. Memphis Depay. Green parallel numbered to 99 of Gabriel Jesus. A couple of base cards. There's the base. Jesus. Thomas Muller.
While you get into this, it's not UEFA, it's actually MLS. We have our very first ever Future Watch soccer column up on GoGTS.net, the hobby's resource. If you're not familiar, GoGTS.net not only has checklists, sell sheets, product info, but has columns on some of the guys you need to look for. And the soccer one is actually written by a friend of mine, Dave Denholm, who's the official voice of LAFC Soccer Club. He knows his stuff. So check that out on GoGTS.net.
Yes, thank you, Dave. That was excellent. Great to work with you.
One of the things that we can always, or that we often overlook, and one thing I wanted to ask Dave, maybe next time we talk to him, the hobby is international. And especially if you're a buyer and a flipper, there's some extreme opportunities in soccer, mainly because it's hard to get overseas sometimes. So if you know what you're looking for and you know your stuff, there can be some good opportunities here. So pay attention to the website for that.
Gareth Bale, refractor. We saw a standout strikers insert just a little while ago, but this one is a gold refractor number to 50 of Romelu Lukaku.
Should I get a picture of that?
Here. All right, here it is, upside down. Nice! Thomas Muller. Green,
just caught up. There's a weird
green
there.
Wave Prizm, numbered to 99.
How do you spell that last
name? Or
Pulsar.
Sorry, I'm getting my manufacturers mixed up. How do you spell Muller?
M-U-L-L-E-R,
with the two little dots over it. Yeah.
4.16 million followers.
Even I knew that guy.
So here's exactly what I'm talking about. You think that a guy like that is popular? That's more followers than... That might even be more followers than Mike Trout. Let's get crazy. Who wants to get crazy with me? It is. It's more followers than Mike Trout. So y'all out there chasing Mike Trout like crazy while Thomas Mueller sitting out here with worldwide demand tweeting out, thank you, Dirk. Sorry, not even thank you. Danke, Dirk Nowitzki. A video with him and Dirk hanging out. That's the guy that you want to be collecting. That's the guy you can get on the cheap. And if you offer international selling and are patient, you can get some action going on. Good stuff, Rob. Good stuff.
Christian Pulisic. I believe this is his first ever Champions League card. Ooh,
of course,
purple is pretty. Number to 250.
There is actually another thing to keep in mind, though, if people care about this. Am I just talking out my butt too much about soccer? I mean, we're showing soccer cards, so I can talk about it, right?
Absolutely.
So I was at the National this year, and I got the chance to attend without any swag, but very cool just to be in the room. I just don't want y'all to think that I'm balling and rolling it over here. Got to attend the Panini party, and I sat at a table with a couple of dealers from Germany. One, an expansion set, but then also learning how the rest of the world looks at this. And the one interesting thing they told me, that they have a difficult time with mid-level product, which I think it's fair to say that Finest would be, simply because Europe for 50 years had stickers. Rob, you can tell us, what do stickers cost, a pack?
A buck?
Yeah. Now, they will go and they will spend $200 a day on stickers during a World Cup year. But the high end is new to them. The value of the high end, you know, the National Treasures and the Flawless, it's been a bit of a learning curve on the middle end for these shop owners trying to sell like a $20 autograph. So something else to consider. But again, that also could mean the main thing is not to buy what's hot, it's to buy.
That's right. Our second auto is Rud Varmer. So we will give both of those away. And the last pack, just in case we hit the one of somebody. Nope, but we got a pretty blue of Thomas Mueller, which I'll pair with the auto. See, aren't you glad we opened that?
Nice.
That's numbered to 150. I didn't say banana. All right.
I'm going to go on mute real quick while I go post that new tweet to GoGTS Live's Twitter account.
I got to clean up some wrappers before we dive into our next break, which I know many of you are excited for. We're going to take a look at this year's Gypsy Queen. Okay. So two on-card autographs per box. And a three chrome box topper. We'll save that for the end. Working the stacks from left to right. Start with this one. Eight cards per pack. I think one changed this year. Didn't these used to have a mini per pack? I'm not finding any minis.
Yeah, I was going to say it's a hard configuration to keep up with.
Yeah. Usually I remember them sliding through and falling out.
Yeah.
Pretty cool design this year.
Yeah, this is the other one where I think the base design is better than ever before. Topps really paid attention to removing the dullness.
Are there purposeful error cards like No Name on Front?
Yep. In fact, why? Did you look at a No Name on Front? Because I think those are the rarest. Oh my goodness. Who is that? Wow.
Franmil Reyes. Franmil Reyes.
2020 of the World Series champion Padres.
Tyler Glasnow, red hot this year.
This is exactly what GoGTS.net is for, to check the odds on things like these. So here's where they're rare. So what card number is it?
Well, it's so tiny. And see, I don't know how...
No, the number, not like the little black code. Like the
card. No. I am. Sorry. It is... Dude, it is so small. If you are collating this set, I feel so bad. Look at that right up there.
The base nameplate.
289 in a series of 320.
So the question is, where do the SPs start? Ah. We were close. So the number 1 through 300... our base, and those no nameplates fall 1 in 21 packs, so we would expect one of those. However, the short prints, the missing nameplates are 1 in 536, so that's where it gets crazy.
Here's one of the fortune teller cards, Max Scherzer insert.
So it's a cool insert, it's just not super rare. So whoever I saw that had one listed really, really high must have been one of the high number.
Gotcha.
So there's a lot of crazy stuff going on. Oh, that's why GoGTS.net is exactly what you need to use when you're opening boxes of stuff like this.
There's your guy, Yu Darvish.
The minis are in Allen and Ginter, not Gypsy Queen.
Yu Darvish is being sued by his neighbors in Evanston because he built a solid wood fence around the property, obliterating his neighbor's view of Lake Michigan. Yasiel Puig, the Joker tarot diamond card. That's pretty cool.
What's really fun, and it's not exactly annoying. Generally, it would be annoying, but I love all of you, so it's so cool. We've had like 3 tweets today saying, oh, hey, I need that card. And it's not all about the big hit. It's like, oh, I need that rookie, or I need that fortune teller parallel. I need that Christian Pulisic card in my life, go outside guy says. That's fun. They're going to get mixed in and given out in prize packs and things like that, but keep doing that. We like seeing what you collect. We like that you get excited seeing these cards. It used to be common in GQ, but now they're in Allen and Ginter only. Allen and Ginter. Dodger Dennis is watching. Same with Random Guy 43. But who's over in Twitch? I haven't been in Twitch for a while.
Also, there's our first auto, noticing this one of Carson Kelly.
Ooh, formerly of the Cardinals. Now I believe he's with the D-backs organization in the trade that sent future MVP Paul Goldschmidt to the Cardinals, much to my chagrin.
Chagrin.
Ivan Chagrin Lovegren. Boom, boom, boom. I see those booms in the Twitch chat. Keep them coming. Also, if you haven't subscribed yet, click that subscribe button. If you've got Twitch, if you've got Amazon Prime, you can subscribe for free. Carson Kelly's been a hot prospect for about 6 years now. It'd be nice to see him finally come through.
If you like soccer, I don't know if I mentioned this already, but next week's early, probably Tuesday, Twitch stream is going to feature a dual box break of soccer featuring Topps MLS and 2019 Donruss soccer. So Panini and Topps going head-to-head on a Twitch dual box break segment with the giveaways going exclusively to Twitch subscribers. This parallel's number to 250.
Another Padres World Series 2020 winner there. Future World Series winner, Joey Lucchesi. Randa Bechtel saying, I just really like the design of these. She pulled a Paxton number to 250. I agree. This is a good set. This is the kind of thing that...
There's your boy Chris Bryant.
I don't begrudge not getting a giant hit in this. And again, similar to Inception, I've said it before, I'll say it again. The little added color this year makes this so much better of a set than it has been in past years.
I would agree with that wholeheartedly.
Now, I actually went on one of my Twitter video rants about the fact that some of these inserts, these like fake errors, I don't like. And my biggest thing is that I don't think they add anything to the card.
There's so our second auto on that card of Raisiel Iglesias.
So we got a nice red little, and a cardinal.
Nice little numeral and or jersey number inscription there.
But I say that because, Rob, even like pulling a no nameplate card, it doesn't give you the experience of pulling something like a refractor or a superfractor, right? Like that is a cooler card than the base version of it, right?
Correct.
Now, do you feel that pulling a card with a missing logo is cooler than the base version? Or is it just...
Some people might. I'm just not that type of collector, so I don't think I can speak to that. Two of Wands, Xander Bogaerts, another tarot of the diamond card.
And that was one of the reasons why I did the video too, is because again, as you pointed out, you are not into that. One of my questions was, are there people who do think that that's really cool and really like that and think it enhances the card versus is just a A way
another
to
fortune teller insert. This one of Jacob deGrom.
Because I will tell you another, like, a variation that I like. I like image variations. I think that's cool. You know, the guy's base card is him standing posed with a bat, but then you can get this card of him diving for the ball.
Sure.
I think that enhances the cardboard.
So I've been looking for other anomalies as I've been going through these, albeit admittedly rather quickly because of the quantity of the packs, but I haven't noticed any other anomalies.
Speaking of anomalies, whatever happened to Incubus, man? They were so big. And then they went and tried to take on George W., and it kind of backfired, it seems.
I missed the first part of that. Whatever happened to what?
Incubus.
Incubus.
Yeah, the band. They were, like, so hot for, like, three albums. And their last album... And their last album was good. Politics aside, it was a good album. But it was, like, after they got super political with that last album... You just never heard from them again.
I
don't
blame
think
the
Secret
heroin.
Service did it, do you?
Nah, I blame the heroin.
I guess that could do it.
Another fortune teller. This one of Freddie Freeman. Last year's NL Rookie of the Year, Ronald Acuna Jr.
Ooh. Any sort of variation action with that?
I don't think so. I mean...
Was it in the middle of the pack? Well, the other way to tell is the little black numbers that are probably even smaller at the very bottom of the card.
Oh my gosh, I can't read those.
I will tell you, looking at the front, that is the photo on his base card. Now, whether it's the one that has a sparkle on his butt or not, I don't know. Sparkle butt parallel. If we ever get a Ren and Stimpy set, that has to be a thing.
There was a Ren and Stimpy set. You mean if we get a modern one with all the bells and whistles? Tarot of the Diamond, Edwin Diaz.
The Ren and Stimpy set was actually a Prizm prismatic foil 50 card set.
Yep.
Man, they were ahead of the curve.
Yeah, wasn't it Inkworks or Comic Images that did that one?
I don't know. None of the people still listing it care about that so much as showing the pictures. It says from Tops on this listing.
Was it a
showing
Tops?
Backs of the cards.
Oh yeah, I mean that does make sense. Tops has always been synonymous with what's hot in pop culture.
Yeah, the Tops company. Way to go, Tops.
Edwin Diaz, fortune teller. Jose Altuve, Didi Gregorius, Willie Adams, and our last pack. Before we take a look at the chrome box topper, just once I'd like to pull an auto in a box topper. Never, ever, 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 ever have I opened one of those box topper thingies and pulled one of the auto variations. Three chrome cards inside. Chrome Gypsy Queen. You know what? I really like these. I really, really like these. These are cool.
What was I saying, Rob?
I, oh man, this is...
You put the right kind of foil and shine on something.
That's really impressive. Oh, and check out the Carlos Correa gold refractor numbered to 50. That's cool. All right, we didn't get an auto, but we got a really cool card. Those are sharp looking. Wow, I like that. All right, so we've got
Correa, Adams, and who else? I missed the third one.
Correa, Adams, and Michael Franco.
Oh, wow. Yeah, none of those too shabby. The Otanis and Acunas from that are going for sort of ridiculous dollar.
All right, so we're going to do three winners from this one. We're going to give away all the inserts and that cool Carlos Correa to one person, and the two autos individually to two other people. So Carson Kelly, Raziel Iglesias, and Gypsy Queen inserts.
So a fun insert bundle for someone. That'll be awesome. We'll get that up in just a moment here. After I stop drooling over the fact that Pete Alonso just hit a 454-foot homer with a 118.3-mile-per-hour exit velocity.
You know, isn't it funny, exit velocity? It's all the rage now. You never heard it 2 years ago. You know what's interesting is that the youth movement in baseball seems to know no bounds. I saw Baseball America posted a tweet today. Something like 12 or 14 kids under the age of 22 started the season in AAA. It's just amazing.
There's actually an interesting conversation piece with that, if we can steal two more minutes from our already packed show, which is now that we are through, allegedly, the PEDS era, you don't have as many guys lasting 30 or 40 years,
mm-hmm.
or to the late 30s and early 40s in the league. So it kind of makes sense that there would be a little more turnover and you'd be seeing a little more leaning towards the youth. Now, the other question is baseball really clean?
That's a whole can of worms for another day, my friend, because now it is time for part one of a busy week of Hot in the Shop. A look ahead at next week's new product releases, and we kick things off with some hockey. Some CHL hockey, to be specific. Ivan, can you do me a favor?
Yeah, what do you need?
I need you to take that because I opened all the wrong links. I opened all the break links.
I've done it before. I've opened them in reverse. I've done all of that. And I am more than happy to take the Upper Deck CHL hockey cards, where each box is going to deliver an autographed card as well as 12 star rookies and 10 insert cards. And as Rob mentioned, the youth movement in baseball, we're also seeing the youth movement in hockey, where thanks to the internet and advanced information, hockey prospects are beginning to be a thing. Well, this includes the top players from the CHL. You know, Canada, hockey is king. So where else would you want to be pulling your pre-rookies from than the CHL hockey set? Solid mix of inserts and autographs in every single box, along with the exciting technology of Upper Deck Parallels. There are the rookies exclusive parallels numbered to 100, high gloss parallels numbered to just 10, base set autographs, and then also rookie SPs auto parallels, and the inserts featuring top level talents, scouting reports, Memorial Cup ambitions, and top prospects SP cards, which are 1 in 120 hits, with a 300 regular card base set and 100 star rookies, one per pack. This is an exciting, exciting product for those of you that are deep into the NHL and want to go even deeper with CHL hockey cards from Upper Deck.
I'll let you take this next one so we get back on track, because I know soccer's right up your alley.
I'm pretty excited about this one, too, especially after the top's finest UEFA Champions League box we just opened. Well, they are continuing the UEFA Champions League sets with museum collection soccer cards. Each box is going to have 8 cards and deliver 1 autographed card, 1 autographed relic card, and then 1 regular relic card, along with a couple of base card parallels and regular base cards. This has some of the most spectacular autograph and memorabilia cards of the world's greatest footballers across an array of low-numbered collectible subsets, including archive single autographs and dual autographs, Road to Madrid, highlighting the best players from each team in the group stage of the 2018-19 Champions League, framed autographs, 1 per case, showcasing the biggest autograph signers on a framed card numbered to just 50 or less, depending on the parallel. And the autographed relic cards, the museum autographs with jersey swatches, autographed jumbo relics, and museum framed autograph patch cards, another premium hit highlighting autographs of the top players in the UEFA Champions League. And then look around for some momentous material, prime patch relics, single player triple relics, and of course 2 base card parallels in every box with the premier checklist of the top UEFA Champions League athletes. Very excited to have this hit hobby shops next week on Wednesday.
And NHL hockey fans have a product to look forward to of their very own. When 2018-19 OPC Platinum NHL Hockey Cards hits hobby shelves, it's going to deliver 1 autograph card signed on card, 6 retro variations, 5 rainbow parallels, 2 numbered parallels, and I love the name of this next one, 2 violet pixel parallels in every box. The 16 box case is configured with 2 8 count inners, 20 packs per box, and 4 cards per pack. Look for on card rookie autographs on dazzling platinum card stock. Platinum Hockey features a 200 card base set comprising 140 active veterans, 10 retired greats, and 50 marquee rookies. A set builder's dream, collect all 8 levels of parallels, including rainbow, violet pixel, red prism, new this year, Arctic Freeze, seismic gold, the hobby-only orange checkers, emerald surge, and the ultra-rare golden treasures 101. Look for plenty of new inserts as well, including the platinum retro cards and the all-new houndstooth pattern parallel. Cool. Collect an array of dazzling parallels, new inserts, and much more when this hits shelves next week.
And then very finally, we've got, for part one, 2018 Leaf Metal Perfect Game All-American Baseball Cards. These are beautiful, actually. I've got some of them myself in my PC of some of the guys that I like to prospect. The All-American game is just getting more and more future stars, better players participating, and more hype around it. Well, this product has only 109 total cases produced, so it is very limited, very allocated, and only 52 top draft prospects were invited to participate this year. So you see the cards there from the sell sheet, really great looking cards, great technology. You know, this is really fun too, because Leaf is not required to use stock footage or stock images from the website. They actually have photographers that they send to get these exciting dynamic images. There are also very rare patch autographs using the incredible jerseys, caps, socks, and pants worn during the photo shoot for these cards. And again, in true Leaf style, they make sure that they are chunky, punchy patches. We absolutely love that. Along with variations using wave foil technology. Most cards in the autograph set are numbered to 50 or less. So again, rare, packed, incredible product for the deep baseball collector. This hits hobby shops on Friday next week.
And that's just part one of what's releasing in hobby shops next week. Before we dive back into part two of our box break segment, Recent WWE Hall of Fame inductee Tori Wilson has a quick message for you guys.
What's up, you guys? WWE Hall of Famer here, Tori Wilson, and you are on GoGTS Live, the Hobbies web show with two of the sexiest damn guys I've ever met in my life. The one, the only, Rob, and the one, the only, Ivan. K2 and onlys. Aren't they hilarious? I just love you guys. Keep it up. Love you. Keep tuning in for the rest of you. And hey, we'll see you guys soon.
Thanks, Tori. I think you're pretty sexy too. All right. So, you want to open some more product?
Of course I do. Especially after a compliment like that.
I had a nice conversation on Twitter today with Lance Fisher of Onyx Authenticated, thanking him for sending me a package to share with you guys. And this product's had a lot of hype, and we've been really excited to see it firsthand because it's something different from Onyx. Platinum Elite Edition has been a popular baseball card brand of theirs for several years. They're mixing it up and doing something with a little bit more vintage retro feel, but still delivering on-card autographs. Current SRP on this product's $50, and you're going to get two autos. So let's check it out. Four cards per pack, two on-card autographs per box. And in every case, redemption for a graded star rookie, 1950s or later. One premium hit in every case.
That would Is this it. The worldwide debut, technically?
When does it release?
I mean, I haven't seen any of it yet, and I've been...
It must be the worldwide debut! Oh.
Oh, now we're hearing that it's not. That it's actually already been out. That there's single cards on eBay. Ah, well, still, it's our debut.
All right, so we've got a little cello, cello pack going on. I like it, Pedro Castellanos. Geraldo Perdomo. Boom! Wander Franco.
Whoa! The
boom! Green ink Joe Adell.
What? Look at that. Oh, man. So fast, I couldn't even get an image of the first one.
I know. One. Sorry.
No, that's fine. I understand. When the boom comes like that, you got to rat-a-tat-a-tat it like a machine gun. Wow. Onyx Joe Adell. Onyx, Wander Franco. Let's see that Franco again. Oh, that's great. Yeah, hold them both like that. So the green, is there a number on that?
No. I don't think they wanted to use any foil or anything.
Well, sometimes actually with Onyx in particular, they actually
hand number them. Yeah. I don't see one.
Wow. That'll be interesting. So Wander Franco, you can't even get yet in a Rays uniform on anything, on this really super cool vintage stock. And I've said it before, I'll say it again. The best thing about these cards is that Lance Fisher of the company posts to social media when he's doing the signing. So you can actually see the guys with the cards in their hand. Lots of transparency, lots of getting close to the athletes. That is super cool. Super cool.
Do you want to do it again?
Rob, one, why do you do this to me? It's just like, yeah, of course I do. That's the answer. But just the, yeah. You always hold things in reserve, and it just, I don't know why it kills me when it makes me so happy and giddy too. But this is fun. I can't wait for the National to actually see some of these cards in hand, because unfortunately I don't think I'm going to be able to buy a box any sooner than that. But wow. If there's any left by the National.
Ah, Freitas Nova. I just wrote a card back bio for that guy. Heliot Ramos. Geraldo Perdomo. Boom! We got a redemption for a 1989 Upper Deck BGS graded Ken Griffey Jr. rookie card. Yes. 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 Wow. I'm going to put the Perdomo in a prize pack. We don't want to forget our prize pack, people. I think this replaced the second auto. Did you get that? Oh, you know what? We'll just give that away too. Come on.
What? Was there any question?
The Geraldo Perdomo. I originally said we'll prize pack that one.
Oh, Geraldo Perdomo. Oh, sorry. No, yeah,
we'll give that away too.
Okay. Awesome. Give the people what they came for. And I don't even know about him. That's the other thing with Onyx is that Lance has got his finger on the pulse of young, exciting prospects. So... you never know who that guy might turn out to be. Hey, Rob.
You want to do it again?
If this goes on much longer.
This is the last one, I swear.
Okay. I mean, I'm almost afraid to, like, because of what we just got, this has to be a letdown, right? Right?
For those of you who are attending the National this year, Lance has told me that he set an entire case, 24-box case of this, in reserve to open and give away live on stage at this year's National Sports Collectors Convention. That's one case hit and 47 autographs. Wow. All right, so we've had an Odell, a Wander Franco, and a graded, don't know what grade yet. Could be a 10 for all I know.
I have to imagine it's got to be a 9 or a 10. I don't think that Lance would waste collector's time with a 7, especially as a case hit.
Julio,
I could see
Pablo
a 9
Martinez.
Being in there just because of feasibility, you know, getting it.
Marco but. Luciano. I like this kid. I like this kid, guys. Freitas Nova. Get in on him now. As well as Eric Pardino. You know what? What you're going to find if you open an entire case of Lance's product, you do see some repeats with autographs because he doesn't go deep. He doesn't go deep. He says, all right, these are like the 20 top guys. This is who we're going to use.
And he keeps why there's not a lot of cases of it either.
Right, exactly. So we'll get both of these away as well. Pardino and Nova.
All right.
I'm going to get up early, fix my coffee, check into the GoGTS Live shipping department Saturday. And can you believe I got all that stuff shipped out before I left for the weekend?
No, I couldn't believe
that at all. I was pretty proud of myself. All right. Okay, let's switch manufacturer gears. This came as a surprise today. I knew we were going to have the Topps breaks, and I knew we were going to have some Panini breaks, and I knew Lance said he would be sending. When I opened my mailbox, there it was. So a little bonus. All right, what do we got up first? Our first opportunity at a Kyler Murray autograph as we were going to dive into Panini Prizm draft picks for 2019. 5 autograph cards per box. What does that QR code do?
So it's kind of funny.
Interesting. Yes.
Well, I was just thinking if you want a funny personal collecting story. Also, because of my industry outside of this, I try to be very transparent. If I'm talking about a guy and I own his cards, I pretty much try to tell you that. A lot of you know I've had, over the course of the past year, I bought, and I shared when I bought them, 3 Pete Alonso cards. But I'm genuinely excited for the guy. And when I brought up his homer earlier, I actually got a text from a friend saying, you better sell your last Pete Alonso right now. On the same notifications, I had my last Pete Alonso has been listed for a while, and I've been getting offers on it, and I had someone just buy it outright. So I've got a message saying, you better sell that, and one down here saying, sold for the complete amount. But man, I tell you, he's exciting. The Mets are exciting this year. Even without having his cards, I'm excited for him.
Melvin Gordon, there's a little All-American flashback from his days at the University of Wisconsin. We have a purple Prizm unnumbered of Julio Jones. A orange unnumbered rookie of Damian Harris. Hey, how about the LSU Tiger mascot? Jerry Rice State. Lamar Jackson, the University of Louisville. And a rookie auto of a guy with an absolutely fantastic signature from the University of Toledo, Cody Thompson. Cody Thompson, Prizm autograph, rookie autograph. So we'll give that away.
Again, there's 5 autographs in this box, but they're not one per pack. Sorry, I was reading 8 cards per pack. So they are one per pack. So if you go to your LCS and they've got an open box,
Kerryon Johnson,
you don't have to worry about cherry picking.
Baker Mayfield, All-American. Ooh, love this. University of Illinois, Red Grange.
Rob, you are going to have to move that card in the background for me to get an image of whatever the next auto is. It's taking too much light from the camera.
Royce Freeman, orange, Prizm.
Ooh, that's a shiny card. And that orange against his Oregon Ducks uniform. That's pretty crazy.
Danielle Jones.
I think it's Daniel.
Yeah, I know. We've got a Prizm.
Joking over here.
Prizm X-Fractor or something, a little bit of different one, and an autograph entirely opposite of the first one we pulled. For the effort, Gary Jennings Jr. from West Virginia. Prize pack that one.
So, I don't know, Rob. I say this, it seems like every other show this comes up. Sometimes guys just have squiggles. That looks sort of artistic to me, though. That looks more creative than I could come up with. Like, getting the Jennings in there, the J-E.
No.
I don't know.
It's C-J-E.
But it's
all right, so it's a little bit artistic. I'll give you that much.
I mean, it's just me.
Michael Irvin.
But I think that's a lot better than like the Mo Wagner, which you clearly see is just a squiggle.
Dickerson.
It's like put your mark on it, and there's an X.
Clayton Thorson, orange. Saquon Barkley.
I don't even know. Who are we looking for besides
Juju Smith-Schuster? I don't know. This class is definitely not like other classes. What I'm personally looking for are the first Panini-produced Notre Dame cards. Dan Marino. Stained glass. That's the second stained glass card we pulled. That's pretty cool. And, I know. I know one of the guys we were looking for. Out of the University of Clemson, Hunter Renfrow. That's solid.
Are you sure? I thought he played for the Padres.
Definitely give that away. And Emmett Smith. Julio Jones. Holy cow. This next one's crazy. I'm going blind. It's numbered to 49.
Oh, mascots card. You know how I feel about college football cards, Rob. That is the exception. A parallel of a mascot card, that shiny. Yes, let's do it. Just add a paw print on that, and you have the card of the year.
J.J. Arcega Whiteside, Crusade. I know I pronounced his name wrong from Stanford. He's a good player. I know that. Todd Gurley the second, Herschel Walker. I wonder if there's die cuts of this stained glass card, because I think these would look awesome if they were some die cutting to them. This one of Peyton Manning. And out of Boston College, Zach Allen. Prize pack. Eric Dickerson again, different pose. The Nittany Lion mascot from Penn State. Adrian Peterson from his days with the Sooners. Sharing the alma mater, Baker Mayfield.
Now that would be a dual auto card.
Amari Cooper. Brett Favre. University of Southern Mississippi.
Haskins. Someone's looking for this guy, Haskins. Have you seen Haskins?
No, he's an Ohio State guy. J.J. Arcega, again, a purple Crusade card. Not numbered, though. Why not? That should be numbered. And out of the University of Nebraska, hey. Stanley Morgan Jr.
Autograph?
Yeah, we'll give that away. So three winners out of this box. Stanley Morgan Jr., Hunter Renfrow, Cody Thompson.
All right. And then real quick from the last box, are we giving away those other two guys that you hit, the last two?
What was the other box?
Pardino and Francisco, the Onyx, right before this?
Yeah, Nuevo and Pardino.
Both of them also. Okay, cool. All right, what's next?
You want more? We got more.
I mean, I've come to expect more, Rob. This is on you. You are spoiling me. You are a bad parent to the collectors out there with what you are giving away.
All right, let's go back to the diamond, this time in the form of 2019 Diamond Kings Baseball with the packaging featuring one of my PC guys, Shoeless Joe Jackson himself. 12 packs per box, 8 cards per pack, 2 autograph or memorabilia cards. Baseball cards right there.
Oh, whew, sorry, I had a sneeze go nowhere. The old sneeze go nowhere. Big mistake.
All right. The look and feel of Diamond Kings. Ricky Henderson. Rookie Corbin Burns. Legend Stan Musial.
Only one autograph card in this, but it could be a framed parallel autograph, which would be really cool.
Ryan O'Hearn.
Or a retro 1983 Diamond King material signatures.
Ted Williams. Jacob Nix.
Hey, did we ever get, where did that Ted, wasn't there a Ted Williams auction that we talked about a couple weeks ago? Do we know where that ended?
I could try to find out. Gallery of Stars. Beautiful card of Alex Bregman.
But there's no logos. Yeah, I'm mocking you right now, collectors, because that is a beautiful card. Full team color on display and very cool art.
It's beautiful.
Sometimes I gotta go there.
Here's a really great relic card. Dual relic card of Brooklyn Dodger fame. Eddie Stanky, numbered to 49.
That is something so cool about Diamond Kings, is that they hold true to the vintage relics year in, year out. Where else are you going to pull an Eddie Stanky jersey relic?
Boom!
Numbered to just 49.
Give that away for sure.
Something I know.
Roberto Clemente.
Dodgers fans watching with love.
Josh James. Satchel Paige.
In fact, one of them, Dodgers Dennis, says specifically, GoGTS Live is really just assisting me in procrastinating from doing my homework.
Chipper Jones.
Me too, that homework being taxes. Freddie, I still haven't finished them.
Freeman. Joe Wood. The 300 homage to the 300 game winners, Tom Glavine. How about a beautiful framed parallel of Charlie Keller? That's gorgeous.
Well, I got caught down a Eddie Stanky relic path, which is not what it sounds like, first off. He's got some beautiful cards and National Treasures and Flawless throughout the years, including a triple with Pee Wee Reese on it.
Andrew Benintendi. Wow, how about a serious throwback crowning moment Diamond King card of Jason Giambi. Love it. You like retro, you like vintage, you like old school. Look at that. Walter Johnson Diamond Kings. This is the 1919. What Diamond Kings would have looked like in 1919, 100 years ago. Chris Shaw. Ty Cobb. Sam Crawford.
Don't forget, if you like any of these hits and you're watching on Periscope, all you have to do is screenshot and you can immediately tweet out the picture of the hit, just like I do.
How about an artist proof of Shohei Ohtani? Or a flashback Diamond Kings of Randy Johnson with the Montreal Expos. Bringing it back to the modern era with Acuna Jr., rookie Cylon Perez, and Luis Severino.
Out I like this set. 6 weeks.
We did not get this last year. I asked three or four times, and I just don't think that Tracy ever got marketing samples of this product. So I was really happy to see this today. Roger Maris. Rookie Kyle Tucker. Portraits. Javier Baez.
I just saw Chris Davis, ninth fastest player to reach 200 home runs. No one's talking about him. Who knows why?
49 or 50 straight games without a hit. Poor guy.
Wrong Chris Davis.
Oh. Giancarlo Stanton.
Was that purposeful, Rob, or was that...
Honus Wagner. No.
Yeah, so Chris Davis with a K for the Oakland Athletics is the ninth fastest player to reach 200 home runs. Chris Davis for the Orioles, CH, is like 34 years old and, yes, is on a 0 for 50.
Colby Allard.
Streak.
Rookie. He's on everybody's hot list. Colby Allard. Joe DiMaggio. A beautiful framed parallel of DiMaggio's crosstown rival, Carl Erskine. A portrait card of George Brett. Mickey Cochran. Justice Sheffield. And the legendary Christy Mathewson. I like opening this product. It's very fun.
In three different chat rooms, a different individual had said, no one talks about Athletics guys until they leave the Athletics.
Max Scherzer.
Three different chat rooms, three different viewers.
Kristen Stewart. Ramon Laureano. Some guy named Mickey Mantle. Gallery of Stars, Clayton Kershaw.
Ooh.
Ozzy
Talking
Elvis.
Again about beautiful looking cards.
Jose Altuve. Mookie Betts.
Definitely looked better than Triple Play did back in the day.
Kevin Newman. Jimmy Fox. He's one 500 home run ball that's going to elude me.
I never say
I hit
never.
The lottery. Cedric Mullins.
There's two scenarios, actually, Rob. We could also go into some sort of post-apocalyptic nuclear wasteland, in which case, assuming you have the right armaments, you could also get a Jimmy Fox ball under those conditions.
Tukey Toussaint rookie framed parallel. Oh, the way gone too soon. Kirby Puckett. Worst name for a pitcher ever, Walker Buehler.
Yeah, but man, he's proven it wrong, isn't he?
Heat. Yeah. Eddie Stanky, base card. Oh, Aaron Judge, base card. Did you see this week someone pulled a Ty Cobb cut auto out of a retail hanger box?
Allegedly.
Allegedly? You don't believe the retailness of it? I hope not. I think it frustrates me if that stuff gets packed out in retail.
Well, first off, I think that it should be... You know me, Rob. I don't have a problem with collation as long as it's a product of true randomness, because true randomness could actually lead to bad collation.
Heirs to the throne, Chris Sale.
It would be forced randomness to guarantee that you don't get doubles.
Joe
in the product.
Jackson.
I think it's totally fair. Last year there was a Sean Connery one of one cut auto from Heritage that showed up in retail. But the only reason I say allegedly is because I still have difficulty. Every giant retail hit that I've ever seen, it isn't opened on camera. It's shown after the fact. And it's a
well,
great
of
way
of course
to
people just show their hits. I mean they're not anticipating, especially with retail, to film it, Ivan.
Well, that's why you should.
Yeah.
You know, you see something going down on the street, pull out your camera and start filming. You never know. It's the
Jersey
ordinary.
Swatch auto of Max Muncy of the Los Angeles Dodgers. It's our other hit.
Hey, Muncy. So
we will give both of those cards away.
Hold on a second with that.
Oh, I'll put it back.
I got your hand in motion. It was kind of funny. All right. Muncy, he doesn't have a whole lot of autographs out there because he was underlooked until last year. So that's a pretty special card for a Dodgers fan. And if you get it and you're not a Dodgers fan, consider trading it or, you know, like talk to a Dodgers fan in the chat room. Good card there.
Trish Speaker. Last two packs.
Also, I'm hearing, I don't have time to verify it because I'm balancing out trying to get out these tweets, but that we might have shown the code to the Ken Griffey Jr. redemption. Not only shown it, but probably posted it when I posted the tweet. I'm going to go out on a limb and say that's okay. Lance will make sure that it goes to the right person and that hopefully if anybody actually tries to steal that, he'll tell us as well. Permanent ban.
Nolan Ryan. Yeah.
Can I go that absolutely. Far, Rob? Can I
sure.
lay down a hammer?
Boom. Sure. Larry so, Walker flashback, Montreal Expos.
Be respectful. But again, it's Lance and it's a allocated product. It's not huge. It's not like, you know, it won't be hard for us to track that. So,
Michael Kopech. Last pack. Brad Keller, Rhys Hoskins, Paul Goldschmidt, Jesus Aguilar, Thor, Noah Syndergaard showed up at WrestleMania, David Fletcher, Johnny Bench, and the last card of the box is Mel Ott.
Awesome. So I got that
rapper action here.
Diamond King's going up on Twitter right now too. So make sure you go to twitter.com/GoGTSLive. Also, if you like any of what you're seeing tonight, go to GoGTS.net to stay in the know on these products or to read more about them or see more pictures, as well as learn more about the guys behind them. Future Watch column. Some fun interviews out there. Kelsey Schroyer's hobby musings.
Locker room coverage from the NHL with Russ Cohen and much more. All right, last box of the evening. 2018-19 Court Kings. We're going Luca hunting one more time. Two autographs in every box.
Jeremy N just shot us a tweet with a retail box. And a hit, a number to 10, Kyrie Irving from Panini Status.
Nice.
But Jeremy, it's just a picture. How do I know? You could have gone to great lengths to pose that. I expect videos of our retail breaks from this point on. Just teasing you, Jeremy. I appreciate you watching. And nothing makes me happier than some mid-show engagement.
Buddy Hield. Beautiful cards. Emerging artist Lonzo Ball.
So Court Kings is essentially Diamond Kings just on the court, but also at a slightly higher price point, I think.
Andre Drummond.
Much more of a mid-level product for basketball collectors. And I like it. I like the fact that they brought this brand over with the art cards.
John Collins, number to 99. These are beautiful.
Two autographed cards in this. And it actually features Luca on the box, right?
Bruce Brown. No, Kyrie.
No? Oh. They've got him on the sell sheet picture with it.
Anthony Sims.
Portland Trail.
This is one of the four different tiers of rookie cards. See, there's that design and that design. First auto, Impressionist Ink, DJ Augustin. Numbered to just 149. And he's been our guy. He's been our guy in basketball breaks, and he is once again.
TJ Leaf.
Numbered to just 199 on card autograph. Fresh paint of Kevin Knox.
Oh, okay. That's much better than TJ Leaf, who we've also pulled, I believe, three autographs of over the years. much better to get a hot rookie like Kevin Knox. Wow. On that cool fresh paint. Look at that design.
Isn't that cool, Rob, looking? I know
it's late in the show, so I know you're probably a little tired after all that ripping, but man, that's a great way to end it. That is a cool card of a hot rookie who's got a hot future as well.
I can't believe how much stuff. Look at the stack of stuff we're giving away tonight. It's mammoth. All right.
So both those autos going away?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm going to be just a minute getting that tweet up. Rob, what was your favorite thing to open tonight out of all of that?
Diamond Kings. And Vintage Collection. So baseball was my favorite tonight. All right. While you're doing that, I'm going to shift gears to Hot in the Shop Part 2. It's deja vu all over again, Yogi, because it's another busy week in the hobby. Kicking things off. Here it is, guys. 2018 Panini Flawless Football Cards. Delivering 6 autos, 2 gem cards, and 2 memorabilia cards in every box. All cards are numbered to 25 or less, and all autographs are signed on card, unless they're cut signatures, of course. And 2018 Flawless promises to feature more patch autographs and one-of-one cards than ever before in the product's history. Pretty cool. New autograph sets for 2018, laundry tag signatures, rookie dual patch autographs, flawless draft gems, Super Bowl MVPs, captains, rookie booklets, veteran booklets, signature gems, flawless duels, Super Bowl gems. How about some new booklet autographs? Again, all with on-card autographs. Rookie and veteran booklets, signature gems, flawless duels, and Super Bowl gems. New gems for 2018. MVPs, and then some team themes. Bears, Broncos, Giants, Eagles, and Chiefs. New veteran booklets numbered to 10. Nameplate booklets numbered to 8. Brand logo booklets numbered to 2, and shield booklets 1 of 1. This was supposed to release a couple weeks ago. It's going to be out next week.
Rob, I feel like a little kid who just won the lottery since you dished this up to me like a T-ball home run. I am so excited to talk to you about what's hot in the shop this week because it is 2019 Bowman baseball cards. That's right. The flagship Bowman, the first series of the year, featuring none other than the aforementioned and hit today on the show, Wander Franco. His autographs on card, among many others of the hottest prospects in baseball. Each box is going to deliver 1 autographed card, or a jumbo box will deliver 3 autographed cards. It's going to celebrate Bowman's 30th year since its 1989 return. So look for some fun throwbacks, including 1989 Bowman buyback autographs. Fingers crossed that Ty Griffin made that list, along with dual Bowman prospect autographs, including a rare 1 of 1 superfractor. That's hobby only and something that I feel like we haven't seen in the product in a few years. They used to do it in some of their other Bowman lines, as well as All-American Game autographs and the 2019 return of Bowman Sterling, this time as a continuity set throughout Bowman this year. So the much-loved Bowman Sterling line will also be making a small appearance here. The insert sets, of course, the paper and chrome prospects, are those alone are good enough to chase. We've seen chrome prospect cards, just base chrome, go for $50, $60, $70 of some of the hottest prospects this year. So what will they do out of this product? Who knows? Bowman Scouts Top 100 as well. And again, those continuity parallels are very exciting. Go to GoGTS.net for the entire checklist. And if I may shout out a couple other great resources, check out Group Break Checklists or Breaker Culture if you're going to buy into some breaks from some of our favorite breakers to make sure that you get the teams that have the odds for you. This is an exciting product. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah, it will be. And if you like prospecting in football, guess who's got you covered? Sage Hit Premier Draft High Series. We had a lot of fun looking at low series. This one's high series. Don't worry, you're still going to get your 12 autograph cards, your 20 hobby exclusive parallels, and 20 inserts in every box. And it's featuring top prospects eligible for the 2019 NFL Draft. 16 boxes per case, 20 packs, 6 cards per pack. Look for premium portrait insert sets with autographed versions and foil parallels. The platinized subset, a chromium style product numbered at just 25 down to 101s. On-card autographs in the next level signatures. Again, the Dwayne Haskins and Patrick Mahomes 50 TD tribute card, including autographed versions. Sage All Rookie Team Subset Gold Level Autograph Cards numbered to 100. And the memorabilia giveaway continues. Signed jerseys and signed game-worn jerseys from top prospects. Don't call those when you pull them redemption cards. Sage refers to them as exchange cards because that stuff is sitting, waiting for you right now.
That's exciting. Looking forward to that. Hey, guess what? We've got an exciting entertainment product, too, hitting store shelves. So if you aren't into the sports and you're watching this for the entertainment, well, again, there's a reason there's two parts to Hot in the Shop this week. It is huge. Yes, that's right. We have Cryptozoic's Rick and Morty Trading Cards Season 2. Remember, Season 1 was so hot. Your first chance ever to get some autographs of some of the creators of Rick and Morty, as well as some of the celebrity guests. Well, it's time to time travel across the universe again with Rick, Morty, Summer, Beth, and Jerry in the second trading card set based on Adult Swim's cultural phenomenon. You can relive all your favorite moments from classic season 2 episodes like Total Rickall, The Ricks Must Be Crazy, and Get Swifty. It's going to have a 45-card base set, 6 chase sets, and 1 autograph card per box, as well as 1 sketch card per box. Those are incredible, too. Depending on the autograph and depending on the sketch, sometimes the sketch is worth more. That said, extremely strong signers list. That's what one cares about in a product like this. Starting off with Justin Roiland coming back, the show creator. Tara Strong, Keith David, who you may also remember from, what was that movie about the drugs and... anyways, Kurtwood Smith, Trisha Helfer, Gary Cole. Yeah, I'm going to need one of those alien Dr. Gary Cole autographs. Chelsea Kane, Scott Chernoff, Chris Parnell as Jerry Smith, Other Jerry, Another Jerry, Worm Jerry, Shaved Head Jerry, Tank Top Wearing Jerry, Goatee Jerry, and Heroic Jerry, which means they put way too much Jerry in the product, considering they know how we all feel about him. But still, lots of fun. I mean, that's the whole point. This thing is a fun set. I didn't even mention Maurice LaMarche as Miniverse President. Kerry Walgren. Incredible checklist of signers. And they make up for it. And they add to it with the great art, the great sketches. Sorry, I could just keep going on and on about this product. One of the things that's great about Cryptozoic as well is that their image galleries that they share are ridiculous. Tons and tons and tons of pictures of this, so you can preview it at GoGTS.net. Look for it in hobby shops this week.
And last but not least, one more entertainment product with a strong autograph checklist. If you're a fan of Fox's hit TV show by Seth MacFarlane, The Orville, pick up some season one trading cards from Rittenhouse Archives, which is going to deliver two autograph cards in every box. Plus, there's a case hit, the Krill Holy Book fold out card. Sweet. Autograph signers include Adrian Palicki as Commander Kelly Grayson and Seth MacFarlane himself, Kelly Hugh, Rob Lowe, and many, many more. 72 card base set with six cards for each of the 12 original season one episodes, starring Seth MacFarlane as Captain Ed Mercer. Bonus sets include The Bridge Crew, Quotable, The Orville Ship, Tour the Orville, and Off Duty. You're going to get one of those cards in every 24 packs. Wardrobe relic cards at a to-be-determined insert ratio, and Mirror Bridge Crew parallels, one per case. Several different case incentives. The checklist is up on GoGTS.net. This, the latest entertainment hit from Rittenhouse Archives.
Wow.
And that
a week
wraps it up for Hot in the Shop. Woo!
Whew.
Told you it was a BOGO show.
Do you watch The Orville, Rob?
I do not.
Hmm. Stephen Holman says, I love this show. But I'm curious.
Might
I've
have
heard
to check
good
it
things.
Out.
I've heard that it's
yeah,
actually
Yeah, I've heard good things about it, too.
And adventurous. So, interesting to see those two going head-to-head, though. Rick and Morty and The Orville. So...
All right. While you get to work pulling some winners.
Oh, quick update before we switch segments. Thank you to Don for pointing out. Apparently, the Ken Griffey Jr. kerfuffle was not exactly a kerfuffle. That's actually the card number in Onyx's system. The redemptions from Onyx do have to be mailed in.
Mailed
so you don't
in.
Have to worry
That's
about that.
That's what I thought. Yeah.
But still, thanks for keeping us. Thanks for letting us know on task, people that did see that. You know,
yes.
We're your show,
for sure.
So we don't like ruining stuff.
Awesome. All right. Again, a reminder to Twitch subscribers, tune in if you want to. Next Tuesday, we'll announce the time. You're still eligible to win, even if you can't view live. It's one of the benefits of being a Twitch subscriber, and you're not going to want to miss it if you are a soccer fan, because we have Major League Soccer from Topps, and this box is so heavy. 12 packs, 30 cards per pack, 2 autographs per box, Donruss Soccer. All right. And now, okay, so last year we had originally told you about the baseball card documentary Jack of All Trades. We interviewed director, producer Stu Stone, and it's been available in Canada. And it's finally available here in the States on a multitude variety of platforms. I did it right through my DirecTV account online and watched on my then it went to my DVR and I watched it on TV. Anyway, so Jack of All Trades.
Technology guy. Sorry. Go on.
Review as spoiler free as possible. It's two stories intermingled into one. One story, I don't think even Stu knew he was going to go down that road when he first started exploring it. And basically, the premise is Stu's dad was a renowned dealer in the 80s and 90s. He owned a series of stores called Sluggers. And was ahead of the curve in a lot of ways. So his father left at a young age, and Stu visiting his mom as an adult, she's harping on him to clean out his stuff from his room and find this. I know this set has a Ken Griffey Jr. in it, blah, 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 blah. So he takes all this stuff to find out that it's not worth anything. See, it's not a spoiler because we all know that, right? But unbeknownst to Stu. So he goes on this mission trying to find out why. Why? What happened? You know, he's been out of the hobby. And along the way, he talks to a myriad of people, and including Jose Canseco, who basically accused Beckett of rigging the entire market with their price guide.
right?
Yeah.
Like, Jose, what?
They talk to Rob Varies of Burbank Sports Cards. They talk to Tom Geideman of Sage Trading Cards, who was Upper Deck's first employee and the person responsible for bringing the hobby, the 1989 Upper Deck Ken Griffey Jr. rookie card, and the story of that. And amidst that, the swirling allegations of just how many might be out there. And many other notable personalities along the way, including a bum rush of Chris Carlin at the Toronto Expo. I was entertained, but the movie left me wanting a little bit more. I felt like it could have used another solid 20 minutes, but to be able to see the hobby that I love in a documentary length format is good enough for me. I'm not a film critic. I know the difference between a good film and an entertaining one. And I thought this was well done, despite there being what I thought were a couple of holes. But let's put it this way. The ending is impactful and perfectly sums up the story being told through this format. I highly recommend you watching it. Congratulations to Stu Stone. It's currently ranked number 3 on iTunes. And it's definitely, definitely worth the watch.
Well, can I ask you this, Rob?
Yeah.
Because I also do still need... We're giving away a lot of stuff tonight. And I wanted to give as much time to that last tweet to marinate and get every one of you watching entered for sticking with us. So you touched on one thing that I've often found interesting in the hobby, which is the difference between those of us that tweet 250 times a day and someone who's going back to their old cards for the first time. Is some of it the fact that it is that story versus necessarily like a super hobby insider story? Like, talk about the difference between those two things when you're viewing it.
Well, I think... in that sense, you know, a veteran hobbyist is going to know the answer to the quest that Stu is looking for the answer for before he finds it. But the journey that he takes to get there isn't one that you might expect for him to follow to get to that answer. Do you know what I mean? It's like we know the answers, what the answer is, and that it's coming, but how he gets to that conclusion takes a path that will take all viewers in a direction that they weren't ready for.
Okay. Well, that's enough of a hook for me to actually be interested in finding time somewhere in between taxes, kids, day job, tweeting, all of that to check it out on one of the... You said it's available on iTunes, and then I can slingcast it through my Roku to my HD TV on a 401k with a CD-ROM, right?
Is that absolutely. What you were saying? Absolutely.
Right. Well, Rob, as I try to figure out all of that, first off, I've got to announce some winners. I've got to give some stuff away. You've got to give it away. I get the easy part. You get the fun part of actually fondling the cards. I get the fun part of drawing all the names. And I did manage to get it all done thanks to that last question that I asked you. So are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Ready. Is everyone in the chat room right now? So remember, if you are in the chat room and you hear your name, that means that you won. Email us. The email address is right there on the bottom of your screen, right below Rob, my co-hobby host is what I was trying to say. GoGTS live at GoGTS.net. And remember GoGTS.net. I know it sounds like a commercial, but my gosh, use the website. It's great. Future Watch, Diego Rossi of LAFC. So we've got a big list of things here, and there's always a chance I may have missed one. Rob, if it's huge, let me know, and we can just... but let's have a go at it. So starting off, the X-Files, Kevin McNulty hangover from last week. That's going to Scott Laurie. Congratulations, Scott. Viewer Scott Laurie. I'm having a quick... That wasn't who won it last week, was it? That would be really crazy. No, it was Scott Laurie. No, I mean, at the end of the day, there's only 200 or so retweets during the show. It can happen. What's the difference between random and bad collation? So Scott Laurie, email us, gogtslive@gogts.net. Include your name, your email, your address, your mailing address, so we can actually get it to you and what you want. Thank you. Next up, out of the AAF, starting off with the Dante Dye autograph. That's going to my friend Rudolfo, big Pittsburgh fan. Don't know if that... clashes with or goes along with Dante Dye, but thank you, Rodolfo, for watching. Next up, the Duke Thomas autograph. That's going to Chad Reed. I know we've got a couple Chad R's that watch the show. This is Chad Reed specifically from Twitter. And then finally, that Luis Perez auto, possibly one of the best cards you could hit out of that set, is going to Alex Oy. Alex Oy. Also, I'm noticing there's a little bit of lag on the screen sometimes. I don't know if that's just me, but I see some people talking about it in chat. So if for whatever reason I do screw up, I generally say the name two or three times anyways. But let us know and we will make sure that the winners get their stuff. Next up, out of Topps Inception, and thank you, Topps, for an incredible mail day of products to preview today. The Danny Jansen auto is going to Stephanie Krause. Thank you, Stephanie, for watching. Congratulations. Beautiful, chunky Blue Jays patch auto. And then from finest UEFA Champions League, we've got the Vormir auto. The Vormir auto. That's going to Jennifer Buzzard. And then the Thomas Mueller auto and parallel is going to Chad R. So not Chad Reed, Chad R. R like a pirate. Congratulations, Chad. Thank you both, Chads, for watching. Chad Chaddington. All right, and then finally from Topps Gypsy Queen, we start off with a bundle of inserts. Well, that's going to Kamikaze Cards. Congratulations, first-time winner, I believe. Kamikaze Cards. You get a bundle of inserts. The Carson Kelly, which I think my co-host was just showing, that is going to Matt Hannell, who I believe is also another first-time winner. And then the Raisel Iglesias is going to Luca Bustaferrari. Congratulations, Luca, on that win. Ooh, now we have what is my favorite of the show tonight, which is the Onyx Vintage. New brand, new set from them. And man, we hit some crazy names, including Joe Adele, Wander Franco, King Griffey Jr., and some deep prospects, Geraldo Perdomo, Nuevo, and Pardino. Let's start off with the Pardino, Eric Pardino, right? That's going to Stockton Ellis. Congratulations. And then the Nuevo autograph is going to Jimmy Gragg. Email gogtslive@gogts.net. Jimmy Gragg. And then the Geraldo Perdomo autograph. That's going to the Black Squirrel. The Black Squirrel. You might want to send us a Twitter message as well just to verify your identity, Mr. or Mrs. Black Squirrel. Then we have the Wander Franco autograph, beautiful on-card autograph of top prospect Wander Franco going to Dan Calton. Congratulations, Dan. The Joe Adele autograph, which I'm hearing the greens are numbered to 50, even if they aren't numbered, is going to Joe Ranyak. Congratulations, Joe. And then the Ken Griffey Jr., that is going to Alex Kent. Congratulations, Alex. I know you'd asked for the Jake Cave card earlier. Maybe you can trade someone that Ken Griffey Jr. and get a Jake Cave rookie card. I'd do that trade. I'd buy a Jake Cave just to do that trade. All right. Going to football, we've got draft picks aplenty, starting off with Cody Thompson. Cody Thompson is going to Andy Campbell. Cody Thompson, Andy Campbell. They sound like they could be roommates in college. Next up, Hunter Renfro, which I probably misspelled. That autograph is going to Mike Estrich. Mibu, congratulations, Mike. Good to see your name on the list there. And then the Stanley Morgan Jr. from my alma mater, the University of Nebraska Lincoln Cornhuskers, is going to Steve Wright. Congratulations, Steve Wright. Oh, we've got four more, Rob, if I'm counting right. But they are four doozies, starting off with the Eddie Stanky relic, which may actually be Stanky. That piece of jersey is game used and from so long ago. That is going to Logan Ward. Congratulations, Logan. I hope you don't mind a baseball card. I know you're a huge NASCAR collector. Hopefully you'll enjoy this piece of history as well. And then the Max Muncy Auto, another name I haven't seen before, but excited to see a new winner, especially for a hit like that, goes to Michael Helton. Congratulations, Michael Helton. Email the show, gogtslive@gogts.net. Finally, from Court Kings, the DJ Augustine Auto. That's flying out east to James Campanos. He knows the drill, and I know that he's still in chat. And then finally, the Kevin Knox autograph is going to Michael Wiley. Congratulations, Mike. Sweet pain tattoo. Excited to see all those winners. Excited to see all those cards. That Kevin Knox is a beauty. Did I forget anything, Rob? It's time to go. We had a great show.
No, you did great. Awesome job. Special thanks to Dave Jokin for joining us from collectible.com. Be sure to download the app. Thank you to Susan LeJudai at Tops, Lance Fisher at Onyx, and Tracy Hackler at Panini America for providing all of the wonderful product that we were able to share with you guys. Again, congratulations on the success of Jack of All Trades. Stu, I know sometimes you watch. And two programming notes. Again, stay tuned, Twitch subscribers, for notification on the specific time of when we'll stream two box breaks of soccer product early next week. And we will be off next week from our regular show returning the following week.
Which is awesome because I needed a babysitter next week and now I don't.
Bada bing, bada boom. See, everything happens for a reason. So, special thanks behind the scenes to James Gale putting all the magic together. My friend and brother, Ivan Lovegren. You've been watching GoGTS Live, the Hobbies web show. We'll be back in a couple of weeks. Don't be sad. You know what to do in the meantime. Always be collecting. Good night, everybody.